Consumer electronics is increasingly relying on glass screen because of its scalability, transparency, and low cost. Particularly, the display technology relies on integrating LED with display panels as backlighting source. The problem for the integration is the high cost due to the inclusion of several device processing steps to transfer LEDs from crystalline substrate to glass. Therefore, the direct growth of GaN-based LED on glass substrate is essential to reduce manufacturing cost significantly. For light emission, the GaN should be single crystalline, otherwise non-radiative optical transitions will occur. The underlying reason of unavailability of single crystalline GaN on glass is amorphous nature of glass substrate. Here we have demonstrated the direct growth of single crystalline GaN nanowire based LED on glass substrate using MOCVD for the first time. To grow single crystalline GaN nanowires, vapor liquid solid approach is adopted using AU as catalyst. To circumvent the possible AU contamination, GaN shells are conformally grown around GaN core nanowires followed by InGaN GaN multiple quantum well shells. Therefore, the active region of InGaN GaN multiple quantum wells is grown defect free. To evaluate the morphology and crystal quality, FESCM and HAADF STEM are used. The single crystallinity of GaN core nanowires is verified by selected area electron diffraction patterns having growth directions along m-axis. The growth facet of InGaN GaN multiple quantum well shells is semipolar 11-22 plane. The atomic orientation is very smooth, that is the evidence of good crystal quality. TEM was carried out for more than 20 samples and we found same results all the time. Due to the semipolar growth facet of InGaN GaN multiple quantum well, the overlap of electron wave function and whole wave function increases and results in suppressed quantum confined Stark effect. To confirm the high crystal quality, PL of pristine GaN nanowires is carried out at room temperature. A very high intensity band-to-band transition is observed. To evaluate the spatial crystal quality, spatially resolved cathodoluminescence is carried out of a single GaN nanowire. The band-to-band transition is observed with same intensity from bottom to top of nanowires. Subsequently, the PL and CL was conducted after the growth of active region of InGaN GaN multiple quantum wells. The band gap was tuned for entire visible spectrum as there is blue, green, orange and red emission by increasing indium incorporation into InGaN quantum well. The IQE was approximated using ratio of integrated intensity at low temperature to room temperature by considering the freeze out of all defect related transitions at low temperature. The IQE of blue sample was 76%, green 75%, orange 56% and red 36%. The integrated intensity of blue and green emission did not decrease up to 150 degrees centigrade, which is the behavior of quantum dot instead of quantum well. Therefore, time resolved photoluminescence was carried out and radiative lifetime was calculated. The trend of radiative lifetime of blue and green samples exhibited a hybrid behavior of quantum dot and quantum well. Finally, the proof of concept device is demonstrated for the sample having lowest IQE. To inject current, the PGAN is coalesced atop InGaN GaN multiple quantum well nanowires. The top PGAN acted only as current conducting channel, while the bottom wetting layer is used for N-type contact. NiAU was used as P-type contact, while indium is used as N-type contact. We have a plan to demonstrate the transfer of GaN nanowire based LED on flexible substrate. We also have planned to use the same growth approach to fabricate GaN nanowire based LED on thermally conducting substrates such as beryllium oxide and copper foil.